Hi guys, welcome back.
I'm going to go over and show you how to make some of these plants that I use for inside my greenhouse. Some of the tutorials are already in a different video for this, but I'm going to show you a few more. And if you like this greenhouse, I do have this kit on my Etsy shop. All right, so these three plants that I have here were made from one plant that was a fake plant. They're made by Mainstays, and then I'm almost positive I got this at Walmart. Yep, I did. It says Walmart right there on the tag. Okay, so the first thing I did was I separated the pieces. That way I had them separated. After that, I decided what I wanted to use for my flower pot. There's lots of different things that you can use, lids. These are a bunch of leftover things from when my dad was alive. We had these little bottles for his eye drops. And they didn't want them, so I figured I'd use them. These are scoopers from, like, formula and stuff like that that I had for my grandson. These are just contact lens drops that I use. Another thing that we can use for making arrangements. Pretty much anything that you can find, you can turn into a flower pot. So there's lots and lots of options there. You can use some lids, like this one is this lid here. What you're going to need to do is you're going to need to get yourself something to do that with. If you want to do like some pen caps as well, you can do that. If you're going to be using this, what I do is I take the knife, hold it away from where I'm at, and I just cut that off and throw that away. And then I end up taking and just shaving off the rest of that, just like that. And then I just sand it a little bit and it's fine, and I have a taller pot. However, if you want a shorter pot, I just use some titanium scissors and I cut it using that. It's not perfect. You can cut it on a saw, make it perfect. You can use a handsaw, kind of like your craft saw. Put it in your little miter box and just kind of go like that. And then you can get it smaller and probably a little bit more accurate as well. But by the time the leaves cover it, you won't never see it. So I didn't really care about that. All right, so for this one, I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit of glue in here. Now keep in mind, your glue will melt your leaves if it's too hot. So after you put it in there, you need to let it cool off. And if your plastic is super thin like these, you need to be really careful because it will actually melt the plastic. So you just do a tiny bit. And for this one, I'm going to go ahead and do it since it's smaller. Just going to put a little bit in there. You don't need nearly as much. Let that start cooling off as well. While they're cooling off, I'm going to go ahead and finish cutting my leaves off. These are really easy to cut off, by the way. Super, super easy. So another thing you can do is you can go to Hobby Lobby. These are a little bit more expensive, and you can look in their floral section. And then you can get these kind. If you notice, they have very, very tiny leaves on it. I also purchased this one. Now, I think I got some of these with their sale price that they had. They don't have a coupon anymore, but I do think I got it with a sale price. But that's what it is of the regular price. I think they had like 30% off or something like that when I bought it. But the leaves are super small, and it's just in the floral section. This is something I got from Dollar Tree. These kind of look cool if you cut them down. They come in multiple colors. And this is another one that I got at Walmart. As you can see, the leaves are slightly different in color, but they will make several different plants. If you look at that, and then this here can be like a little bush. Then the bigger leaves can be something as well. So with that in mind, understand that you can buy regular flowers to make these. I also have some tutorials where you can use some stamps to make flowers. And I have some tutorials where you can also make paper flowers using quilling stuff. And then there's a few other things on there as well. So check that out under the landscaping section and plants and all on my website. So that's dollhousetutorials.com. This one I'm just going to cut down really low to that first one to make it look like it's still part of that. And then I'm going to cut it again right down, if I can get my thing in there, right down in there. So it will give me three pieces for this one. Now I'm only going to use one of the pieces for the center of this one. And you can kind of pick which one looks the best for you. So I'm just going to stick that in there, and while it's still hot, I'm going to stick a couple of these little leaves in there. You can kind of pull some in front if you like. This one's kind of twisted, so I'm going to stick that right down in here. And by then the glue should be pretty dry to the point that it actually will work for you. Okay, and then you'll get the flower like this. If you like these little yellow pots, leave a comment below because I can put some of those on my Etsy shop for you guys to purchase. These I ordered a whole bunch of them. They make great sandboxes as well. Okay, so this is pretty much dry now. Enough, well not dry, but enough to where I can start putting this in here. I'm going to add this one, make this one a little bit more fuller. And then just kind of throw my leaves down in there. And again, you got to let it cool off some, because if you don't let it cool off, it'll be entirely too hot and it'll just melt your leaves. And if they're melted, then they really won't look right. Okay, and then that's all you have to do to make a plant similar to this one. I did them a little bit different. I didn't want it to be in the same flower pot to look exactly the same for that one. All right. Okay, so this is a wire nut that my dad had in his stuff, so I'm just gonna use it. Why not? Just put some in there. Let that cool for a second. For this one, I'm going to use some of this here. Just going to go ahead and take a couple little bits and pieces off of it, and then we'll see where it goes. never made this before. I'm just kind of winging it with you. So if you hear that noise in the background, that's the teenager. He is home from school because it's in the evening. All right, so there's that. And then I'm just gonna kind of stick this here. Maybe this one, it's got a little bit of greenery coming out of it. So I think I'll just stick that right there. Kind of looks nice. Let me see if I can find a small little flower or leaf. And then there you have that. If you want them to bend, you can always glue them down. Okay, so then that's kind of what that one would look like. I think I will like glue that down just a little bit, just on that front one. And it will also heat that leaf up and melt it, so it should stay. Even if it doesn't stick, it should stay because it'll be bent in that direction. And I may stick another little one in the back here if I can get it in there. There you go. And then that's what that would look like. Well, let's just stick this over here. All right, so you have these little teeny tiny ones too, so you can take some of those little pieces off of there. And you can use the other leaves and make something like that. Kind of looks like a little tiny pink flower. You can color it a little bit if you have paint markers, or if you have acrylic paint, it will stick to it as well. As far as like this one goes, you just kind of pull some of that off of there. I'm gonna slide this out of the way for the moment. To me, you could make some little round clay balls or get some round beads that are red, and you could turn this into a tomato plant very easily, because if you look at that, it looks very, I don't know, it looks like a tomato plant leaf to me. But you could do that very easily. Okay, so with these, if you have one, just take pliers and that pops right off. Wash it out very, very good. You can take this, and I've showed you before how to do this. And just take this right here and just kind of cut it right along that edge. And then you can straighten that up if you want, but it's not going to show by the time you put the plants in there. But there's that. And then this one, I'm going to take it back to this end. Be very careful to keep your fingers out of there. You can sand that down, or you can cut it off very easily and make it flat. Okay, so once you have this, then you can put a little bit of hot glue on the bottom. Just kind of put it on something like that. And then that way you can still use both. And you can have this as the rim or that as the rim. I'm going to have that at the top. I'm just going to kind of put that in there like that. And let that sit right around that edge. And then when it hardens, I'll pull the paper off. Just gonna leave that like that for now. Actually, let me move it over here so I'll have the cord knock it out of the way. Now this is super thin, so you're going to have to be really, really careful with this one because it will melt. a lot faster than the others. This is really, really thin. So we're just gonna kind of let that sit like that, and when that cools off, then we'll add a little bit more to do the filler, or you can put filler in there and then, you know, add it the rest of the way. But we're gonna let that cool completely, and then we'll add more to that. Not quite cool yet. But in the meantime, we'll go back to these. And these you can paint any color as long as you lightly sand it first, or if you use Krylon spray paint, it'll work as well. Sorry for reaching in front of the camera, but I need another glue stick. Okay, so with this one, we're gonna start cutting these little branches off bit by bit. And there's a few little leaves here and there that can come off. We don't wanna waste them. You can always use them for something later if you don't use them now. I think this one is probably too long for what I'm looking for. So I'm gonna cut it like right above this piece here, and I'm gonna do it on an angle. So that way that looks like that's going off into that piece. And again, these came from Hobby Lobby. I'm gonna cut this one off at an angle right at that leaf there so I can continue to use that piece. And then I have this piece. This one is, it looks like the model number is W0456574. I'll hold it there for a second so you can kind of write it down if you want. And then there's a guess maybe that's like a skew right there as well. So if you want to maybe order it online, you can. So for this one, we're just gonna, actually, I think that's still too hot. We'll wait on that. Let me see if this one's cooled down any. That's pretty much cooled down. I'm just wiping off that. It's cooled down there so I can touch it. Inside's still a little bit warm, so I wanna be careful with the inside, but the bottom is pretty warm. Okay, so we'll just use this one for this one. And then we'll just kind of leave it like that. And it'll look like it's a tomato plant about to grow. And then you can add your little tomato plants in there if you want to put tomatoes, or if you want to put flowers. You can do more of these and just kind of make them smaller than this. Cut them maybe in fours and put little bits and pieces around, and it'll look like little flowers. And these are the smaller version. The ones I'll put on my website, if you want to order them, will be the larger versions. Because these, I think I have about 8,000 of them, literally. I only bought 1,000 of the little ones. As if I really ever will use 1,000. Okay, so for this one, we're going to kind of do a little bit more in there. Let's see if it's too hot to melt that yet. Okay, it's pliable. So we'll do that there, and this will be a bigger one. And we'll stick that right in the middle. And leave it like that. Okay, do you remember when I said you could probably use these for like a berry bush or something? I just thought about this. Could probably paint these red and use those as the tomatoes. So that's a thought. Tell me what you think below, and we could kind of use that as that. Now you could also just use it as a berry bush as well. So we're gonna just kind of hold that in place a little bit until it sets up. Let me see. Is it nice and pliable in there yet? Yeah, it's nice and pliable. You want, when you get this like this and you have something really thin like this, you need this to be pretty cool to where you can kind of touch it with your finger and it doesn't burn you. And you can kind of squish it together where you want it to go. And then it'll harden in that way. Got two other things in here that I can use as well. I do really like this here. It's like a cap to something. I don't even know what. I just save everything. I'm like turning into like a recycling hoarder, I guess. But I'm thinking maybe I'll use this one and I'll show you the tag again. So if you want to order it. Thinking I'll use this one because I do like this. So most of them pull off pretty easily. Some not so easy, but most of them pull off easy. So for this one, I'm just gonna do a teeny tiny one first inside of here because I really like this. I don't know why, I just do. And again, this is thin, so be very careful because it will melt through and I don't want you to burn your fingers in the process. So as I'm holding that, it's getting hot, so be very, very cautious when you're doing it. And you got to let it sit down a minute to cool off. This one's pretty hard at the bottom, so because this is thin plastic, remember, we're going to go ahead and do another layer. And then we're going to let that sit so that doesn't melt out of sorts. So I think we will be doing some purple this time. I think the purple is really pretty. And I think I'm going to maybe cut it here, and then I think I'm going to take some of these off if I can get them off. Okay, I was able to get a little bit of them off, so that was great. And then what I want to do, let me see if this is, it's kind of cool, so. We'll go ahead and put that in there. It's a little, it's actually a little too cool. Put that there. Then I'm going to take the glue and I'm going to put a little bit on here. And that kind of sort of looks like lavender to me. I don't know if the leaves are exact, but you can paint the vase or you can leave it clear. It's up to you. And then just put it in your garden or your greenhouse. Okay, so once that's pretty much dried there or cooled down, then you want to go ahead and go right around the inside where you already went, because now you've got a little bit of buildup in there and you want to go ahead and get that started in that same hole. And then you're going to take this. You're going to go on top of that and you're going to twist it and hold it until it cools. Okay, while it's cool, if you want to put any leaves in there, you probably should squeeze them in between the layers. But not while it's completely hot. Just while it's a little bit cold. So I think I'm going to cut this down. Actually, I think I like this leaf better. I don't know what it's supposed to really look like because it's just a purple little bush. Who knows? Guess it could really be anybody's bush. Okay, then you just stuff it in there. And then if you want to put any in there, then you can. Be sure not to get your fingers because it will burn them. I'm going to wrap around the next one. And I'm going to hold it in place. In the meantime, I'm going to cut this right there. One little leaf that's going to go sticking out there. And I'm doing this one-handed, so hopefully you're able to see what I'm doing. And then these two leaves I'm going to stick right in here. Because it's hot, I don't want to put my finger in there. Kind of just looks like three little leaves. All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and finish wrapping some glue around there. And these are styrofoam too, so like the little purple beads on it that's supposed to look like flowers. Ouch, that hurt. I touched where I told you not to touch. Those are styrofoam balls. So some of them may melt away. As I pulled some hot glue out of there, I'll put a leaf on there to hide it. All right, this is the longest this flower is taken because it is, you're trying to glue it in a circle. Okay, now at this point, I'm kind of happy with the way that it's bunched up around the top of there. So it's still cooling, but I'm gonna cut this off right in here. And I'm gonna put a tiny bit of glue right there to hold that down. And this time I'm going to do it without burning my finger. See how that glue is seeping out of there? Be careful it doesn't get you. Okay, so that's what that would look like. And again, you can decorate your little pot or whatever. But this would be kind of like a little bush I would have, like maybe sitting outside or in the garden. Like by the door when you first walk in, because it's pretty bold and you would see it. And I went with purple just because this little scooper was purple. And you can either sand that off or you can paint it or put a handle there or something to make it look like it's decorative. But that's what it would look like. And that's how you're taking the long skinny ones and converting it to something more than just a stick. All right, so this one is a lid to something, and I don't know what, but I'm gonna be using it. Okay, so we're gonna put some glue inside here. Like I said, I'm not really sure what this lid went to, but it's a lid to something, and any lid goes when you're trying to make miniatures, because flower pots come in all different shapes and sizes. And You know, even though it's got a word on there, it kind of, from a distance, it just looks like a decoration. So, it works for me. And it's cheaper than buying a whole bunch of flower pots and turning them into flower pots. But that's what I'm gonna do. And I think what we'll do with this one is we'll just go ahead and maybe make like a little bushy plant with these. So I'm gonna cut that on a little angle there so that shortens that up a little bit there. I think we'll take this one off too, just a little bit. That way we have a couple. Give that time to cool off a little bit so we're not overdoing it. This one is splitting off here, so I'm going to take it at this split and cut that, and then I'm going to go right above this one and I'm going to cut that. I didn't go quite enough. There we go. And then we'll have that. It's starting to get cloudy. If you can see the cloudiness, it means it's starting to cool off. But I can still feel from the outside it's really hot. So I'm not quite ready to use that yet. In the meantime, I'm just going to finish cutting some of these off. I like how that's split in there, so I'm going to keep that. Because this one isn't the best looking one, I'm going to stick that one in first. And I'm just going to let that be a filler for the whole thing. Poor guy looks like he's handicapped there with the no limb thing going on. He needs some help. Poor little dude. And that one looks like he's eaten up, but it's cloudy enough that we can make this work. And it could just be a greenery plant. It doesn't need to have flowers in it. Looks like a Charlie Brown tree. Okay, now I'm just squishing them all together at the base on this one to kind of get it to stand up a little bit fuller, because now that glue is pliable. And then there is another little greenery tree. All right, so here's another one from Hobby Lobby. And this one's metal inside, like it has wiring. So you have to be really careful with that. You can't cut it with scissors. You'll need a pair of clippers. But what I'm going to do with this one is I'm going to cut it down right about here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this one that we were doing. I'm going to put a little bit of glue right there, and I'm hoping that hot glue heats up the bottom a little bit, because I want to push this down. And I'm going to do this while it's all hot, by the way. There we go. It's starting to heat it up now. And it's going down. And there you have one little plant that kind of just would sit off in the corner real tall. And if you want to add little pieces in there, you can do that as well. Just cut them down shorter and maybe stick them in the bottom. you want to give it a little bit of fullness, just stick it down in there like that, and then maybe one in the back. It'll just fill out the bottom a little bit. And I got one left, so what the heck, I'll just stick it in there. You can have a single one, or you can get it like bushy, or if you like it like this, you can keep it, or you can take this here and snip that off, and then you can just have a plant that looks like that. And then again, you can always put a tall one back in there if you would rather have it tall. It's pretty amazing how you can just kind of be creative with these little plants that are meant for normal use. One more thing I think you could probably do with this plant, besides using the leaves individually, I think you could probably turn this into a spider plant, because I think the leaves are pretty cool looking, that you could probably take this plant in combination with this one and hang some, if I could get it to stop sticking to the other one, I'll show you. Take a couple of these off and just pull these little tiny ones off of here. Just like that. Oh, I took too many. Well, that's all right. You'll get the point. And you could just kind of just hang this down off of one of those and just let it hang. And that kind of looks sort of like a spider plant. Maybe put it in some string or something. Try it that way. Try different things. Okay, so if you like these plants and stuff like that, again, Hobby Lobby, Walmart, Dollar Tree, pretty much anywhere you can get the floral arrangements. It just, you have to look at them. Even though they're big, it doesn't really mean that you can't use it, because there's a lot of littles. Like if I was walking past this, I would be like, yeah, okay, on my first peek. But then when I look at these leaves, they are super tiny. So, you know, you can break those off and use them to your advantage. And then these leaves, you could do the same thing. You know, like if you ever seen a hosta plant, the leaves on those are pretty large. So you could take these off and kind of get enough of them, and you could go around in a circle and you could make yourself a hosta. And then glue them like that. So what I would do if I was doing a hosta out of this, I would honestly take a few of them, and I would take one big one and I would take it off, and that would be my base. And they're actually green. I don't know why it's got some kind of powder on it, but I guess that's just how it's done. I'm gonna put a tiny bit there in the center of that, and I'm gonna use that as my base. I go sticking myself with the glue again. It's a wonder I have any fingers left. All right, so hostas kind of go around and they keep going in circles. I don't know if you're familiar with a hosta, but the leaves just keep repeating over and over and over again. So I've got to let that cool off a little bit, because it's not going to let me do much. Okay, so I put another dab in the middle, and I'm just going to go back over it again with some leaves. This one's trying to stick in the plastic here. Scoop some of that glue up there. And hostas also bloom purple a lot of the times. So the top would be little tiny purple flowers. But you get the idea, even though this is definitely giving me a hard time, because the glue's not drying.